There are feats of engineering brilliance all over the place. When we visit these sites, we are just mystified as to how this was done, and this is the case for the Vespasianus-Titus tunnel. Wait, to hear this. The 1,380-meter long tunnel, which was built completely by manpower during the Roman period, continues to draw the attention of local and foreign tourists with its incredible construction work and architectural genius. Deemed the largest tunnel in the world made as created by man, the ancient structure is visited by hundreds of travelers with a love of history and architecture, picturesque scenery, and all things green, as the region is also home to an array of tree species. The water tunnel is also close to the historical harbor city of Antioch on the Orontes on the eastern Mediterranean coast. The tunnel, the construction of which began in the 1st century AD during the reign of Roman Emperor Vespasianus and continued under his son Titus and his successor Antonius Pius, was built to combat the constant threat posed by the flood water that came from nearby mountains in the ancient city of Seleucia, Pyrrhea, in what is now Turkey. To solve this problem, the emperor ordered his legionaries, sailors, and prisoners to dig a water channel through the mountain to divert the floodwaters via a canal, therefore preventing silting the harbor and saving it from becoming inoperative. Canals have been built by former Roman emperors to solve this problem, however, they failed to stop the floods. The fact that the whole tunnel was carved through solid rock with hammers and chisels and has survived to this day without much damage continues to amaze modern engineers and architects. They had first built walking trails, viewing terraces, and stands where local products were sold, and they were now preparing a project to establish a visitor center that would include social facilities inside the tunnel. The Vespasianus-Titus tunnel is the longest tunnel in the world, dug by hand. Next to it, there is also the Basilica Cave, where there are many tombs belonging to important priests and clerics. The cave has also been called the Graves of the Kings, as the tombs are believed to belong to emperors from early Roman times. The tunnel was constructed completely by manpower in order to divert floodwaters to prevent silting the harbor. According to the archaeological records and the various epitaphs on the tunnel, Roman legions and slaves worked during its construction. It was created by opening a canal through the bedrock within a short time. The structure with its water canals connecting to the tunnel, the water bridge, the bridge carved into the rock, the cisterns adjacent to the tunnel, is not only a tunnel, but also is a structure protecting the city against floods and especially preventing silting up of the harbor shaped around the natural lagoons, as well as fulfilling the water need of the city during the summer times. It was designed and implemented according to the needs of the ancient city of Seleucia Pyrrhea. It is one of the unique examples of Roman engineering with its planning and implementation process. From the point of the architectural and engineering implementation, the tunnel is a peculiar structure, being survived till today without any damage. This man-made structure also bears testimony to the Eastern Mediterranean world and Roman diplomacy of the 1st and 2nd centuries AD. Due to its size, well-preserved authenticity, architectural features, and remarkable engineering, the 2,000-year-old tunnel has been deemed one of the most magnificent remains of the Roman period by UNESCO. We found that pretty interesting and just wanted to share it with you guys. Just a short one today, but plenty more to come just shortly. See our links below for more information on this one. Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.